Hi, Anders. I wanted to make a quick video for you about how to get around the lack of shifted characters in Oryx. The reason we can't do this is because what shift does with a character is determined by the computer, and that will change depending on what locale you're using. So US QWERTY will be a little bit different from UK QWERTY, which will be different from, Swedish, all that kind of thing. So to display these, we would need to access the OS settings, and it gets pretty complicated, so we just don't. But you can still configure these manually, and it works out pretty well. So I'll show you how to do that. If you hit modify here on the default, we'll just go with the number row. So I'll be basing these off US QWERTY, but of course you would want to do your own locale for this. So in US QWERTY, this is 1, and then if I hit shift, it's exclamation. And you can do the same thing for all of these. So, this is 2 and at. Okay. And you would continue, but for the purposes of this, we'll leave it there. And then compile. Okay, great. And save it to your board. Okay, great. So if I grab Keymap here and connect, you'll see these labels show up. So this is Keymap's really where the magic comes in. If you're ever not sure about what a character does with shift, you can just keep Keymap open off to the side and use it as a constant reference. You can do this while you're learning or even as you get more comfortable with the board, just in case you need to refer back, it's always there. Hope that helps. Let us know if you have any other questions though. Thanks.